there. I'm Aubrey. And I'm Vanessa.
And we are late to the party and the Candyman is back. Sort of.
So I'm looking forward to this movie because the first Candyman movie is very haunting and beautiful and just the music that, like, it gets in your head, like Philip Glass. The music is the masterpiece for sure. And so them bringing it back and then also having, you know, Jordan Peele behind it, you know, coming in as a producer for it is very interesting because I liked his style. So it'll be exciting to see what they can do with this. And then, you know, we have a fresh, relatively unknown, you know, director in Naya DaCosta. So I'm looking forward to seeing what she can do with this movie.
And I say sort of coming back because we don't know who the Candyman is yet. Hopefully the trailer will reveal that. But Tony Todd is the Candyman. Tony Todd has always been the Candyman in multiple films. Although, yes, that first one is very hauntingly beautiful. And yes, Jordan Peele does have a style in his films, but granted, he's not directing it, so he is producing it. So how much of that style gets to seep into Naya DaCosta's style?
True.
And I'm sure he lets her run free rein in her own vision for the Candyman with a little bit of help from him.
Right.
But it really comes down to the Candyman himself.
Right.
So who are we going to get? Are they going to bring Helen back in? Is she tied in? Is it a sequel? Is it a reboot? Remake? We'll find out with the first trailer for Candyman now.
Say his name 5 times while looking in the mirror. He appears in the reflection and kills you.
Who would do that?
Candyman. These girls. That's what Candyman would do it.
Candyman. Dumbasses.
Candyman. Well, we're still alive. Let's go.
Trina, you broke the door.
This isn't funny!
Ooh, creepy.
I feel really connected to this neighborhood. Cabrini Green. It was the projects. I just moved in around the corner.
The old candy factory.
I'm an artist.
You look up a candy man. He's the monster.
That score.
Part of this neighborhood.
Yeah. Why are you drawn to this?
I'm hoping to spread the story.
Little all Beyonce. Candyman.
The mirror invites you to summon him.
Ooh. You should say his name. I dare you.
Candyman.
Candyman.
No.
Candyman.
Candyman.
Yeah.
Uh-uh.
Woo! It's Anne-Marie.
It is her. She knows. I mean, it's Vanessa Williams.
Yeah.
I think I made a mistake. I'll put him back.
Oh, snap.
Candyman isn't real!
The score!
He had a purpose for you. To be another one of his terrible stories.
I guess he found me. I am the writing on the wall. The sweet smell of blood.
Ooh. Woo.
Be my victim.
This isn't real.
Who was it? Bathroom scene.
I like it.
Oh, man. Are you kidding me?
The trailer music, too.
They
doing the little doing the little Destiny's Child, Say My Name.
And Philip Glass's theme mixed together, too.
Perfect. I love it.
I thought we were only going to get, like, maybe, like, when I heard the piano, I was like, okay, now they're switching to Beyonce. But no.
Well, they switched to Destiny's Child.
Right. Well, it's the Queen Bee in this one. And the bees are back. And I'm wondering, practical effects, the bees were definitely a huge part of Candyman. And man, when Tony Todd had those bees coming out of his mouth too, and even Virginia Madsen with the bees all over her face.
Oh, yeah.
Those are legitimate bees. So I'm wondering, granted, yeah, they're not going to want to maybe
harm the bees.
I'm sure
they had some bees, but not all of them.
So it's probably going to be heavy CG bees, I'm sure. You're not going to get like Nicolas Cage, the bees!
Not the bees! Bees!
But the Candyman himself, I'm so glad they didn't show the Candyman, except for like the reflection of the car window at that one point.
Yeah, but the way that the trailer is portraying it too, it's like it's a reflection of him.
Sure.
So yeah. It's like maybe he's playing this character, but he's also playing Candyman as well.
I could see that.
That's where I got from it.
Right.
Now, it might not be that way. And like we were talking about, too, we saw Vanessa Williams in there. And yeah. Obviously, we know from the first movie she played
Anne Marie.
So, is she playing Anne Marie now?
That was Anne Marie. Like, unless they're bringing her back as a different character. I'm going to look, actually.
She looks good.
I want to find out. Yeah, no, of course. She doesn't... She doesn't age, so if they were making her Anne Marie, then I would assume that, and yep, Anne Marie. Anne Marie is back once again in Candyman. It's a continuation? It's gotta be.
It seems like a continuation. That'd be kind of cool.
It's perfect.
You know, obviously if she's here, her kid is around, maybe it's him, who knows? I mean, he was kind of a good part about the first movie, he was missing, or the child was missing, and then, you know, if you haven't watched it, go watch it, because it's really
good.
It's
on Netflix right now.
It's a good movie,
actually. You can actually watch Candyman on Netflix.
The first one I really, really like, so I am looking forward to seeing how they're going to do this one as well, because I feel like it does kind of bring that sense of the first movie where you feel so entranced with this Candyman character.
Right.
And then, of course, you know, the urban legend of doing it in front of the mirror.
Right.
It feels like, you know, coming back where you have the Candyman and you do the things in the mirror and then, of course, he comes back.
Which, again, it's like an epidemic. Like, everybody's doing it. What the hell is wrong with everybody? I get it. You're all intrigued.
It's more so of like, oh, come on, that can't be true. And then you do it and then, obviously, you know, you don't live to tell the tale. So.
And I do like that he's a photographer, he's an artist, because that does kind of fit a little bit better in terms of what they did in the first one, because in the first one it's like, oh, we're looking for folklore, we're looking for all these different tall tales that have been told about, you know, the side of horror. But when it comes down to it, like, the imagery is very elegant in Candyman, and she's taking pictures of it left and right, but it's like, all right, but it kind of falls apart because she's looking for this folklore, but somebody else already had done the story on the folklore that gives her the information. So it's like she kind of stops looking for the information, and then she just becomes attracted in a way, or entranced by it, or actually haunted by it. And here it's like he's really into the art, he's really into the visual imagery, and more than likely he's going to start bringing it to everybody else too, and that's what ends up happening. The more people know about him, the more power it gives him to be able to basically make everybody his victim. So
I think in a way too that also kind of goes to the first movie as well, you know, how she was like, you know, Candyman's not real, this is not the thing, and I think that's why he also kind of goes after her, because she's like, oh, you don't think I'm real, let me show you, be my victim.
Yeah.
And he kind of
he uses her
yeah, to kind of
get everybody else around her too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Helen, damn it, Helen, you ruined everything in that first movie for so many people.
Yeah.
And it feels like he's going to end up ruining it for a lot of people.
She ruined it for herself as well. So.
She did, but I guess it kind of worked out for her in the end. No spoilers. Go watch Candyman. It's on Netflix. But looking forward to this movie. I'm interested in the imagery, the music. That's what I want to know most about. That Philip Glass score, again, is amazing.
I'm hoping, like they did in the trailer, that they do incorporate...
I feel like they're not going to incorporate it.
They incorporate a little bit. I'm hoping that they incorporate it a little bit in the movie, you know.
Yeah.
Entwine it a little bit, but also make your own, like, Candyman theme, or your own, like, narrative to the story.
When something's so good, though, you want it again, and it's just like, I get it, I'm all ready to move on to a new song, a new theme, but when something was done so well, bringing it back in a different way, it, to me, is better than just doing something completely new.
Mm-hmm.
So we got Anne Marie there, and of course, Tony Todd has got to be there. I like what you're saying about a reflection of himself. You kind of seem like a shadow was taking everybody versus like an actual physical presence, but Tony Todd looks fly as the Candyman, and whoever's donning that Candyman's gonna look fly. That's what I love about the Candyman. He's got style, the movie's got style, the imagery's got style, the music's got style, and we know that Jordan Peele's got it, so Nia DaCosta, I'm sure she will too, but we'll find out when we eventually see more for
the Candyman. So thank you so much for watching our reaction to the first trailer for Candyman.
What did you guys think? Let us know in the comments below which Candyman is your favorite. If you've seen them all, tell us down there. You can also like and subscribe.
And do the thing on our Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, Stardust.
All the social networking gin joints, you know where they are. Kick into the party, fuel the party, keep the party going on our Patreon. Takes the party where we need to go. Thank you so much, and as always...
Now it's time to say goodbye.
Candyman, 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 Candyman. Helen.